In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about introduction of enzyme. Let's first see what is enzyme. Enzymes is also called as a biological catalyst. Biological catalyst. Now the question arises that what is the meaning of catalyst? So catalysts are a substance which have two important characteristics. The first important characteristic is that they increase speed of reaction. Now remember, many students get confused. It is the speed of reaction which is getting increased. It is not that impossible reactions are made possible by the enzyme. Okay, so that must be clear. The second important characteristic is that this catalyst themselves are not consumed in the reaction. Okay, so whatever substance which has these two important characteristics, we call them as a catalyst. Now the catalyst which occur in the biological system, we call them as a biological catalyst. And as I told you, biological catalyst, they are also called as a enzyme. First ever in the history, this enzyme word was given by the one German scientist known as a Friedrich Kuhne. Friedrich Kuhne. He was a German scientist and he had first coined this term enzyme. Why? Because he had derived this word enzyme from the two words. One is en and second one is zyme. In a Greek, en means in and zyme means yeast. Now, during the time of Friedrich Kuhne, it was believed that it is the yeast organism itself which is responsible for the catalysis of many reactions. But Friedrich Kuhne found that it is not the yeast itself, but it is something inside the yeast which is responsible for the biological catalysis. So, to emphasize that it is not yeast, rather it is inside the yeast, he coined the term enzyme. Right, and since then we call all the biological catalyst as an enzyme. Now almost all the biological reactions in our body require biological catalyst. Now just to give an idea, let's see one example to appreciate the fact that how marvelous these molecules are. See, this is one reaction. This is sucrose. Sucrose is the common table sugar that we use in our daily life. This sucrose, by utilizing oxygen from the atmosphere, it can get converted to carbon dioxide and water. And during this reaction, huge amount of energy is getting released. So, as energy is released, this is an exergonic reaction. And we know that thermodynamically, all exergonic reactions are possible reactions. Right? So, this reaction is also possible. But the problem with this reaction is that this is very, very slow reaction. It is so slow that it will require years to complete this reaction. So, we all have in our house, we have bag of sugar, right? Bag of sugar. Now, this bag of sugar, if it is lying on a shelf of our household, then this sugar will remain as it is. Why? Because this reaction will occur very, very slowly. It will take years. So, there will nothing happen. Apparently, nothing happened to this bag of sugar. But what will happen if we consume this sugar? If we take this sugar in the diet, then what will happen? Within the minutes, within 1 or 2 minutes, all of the sugar will get digested and this reaction will take place and we will get energy to do various muscle related work. Right? So, this reaction is made possible to occur within minutes because of this marvelous molecule that is enzyme. So, that's all for this video. In upcoming subsequent videos, we'll visit in depth about enzymes. I hope that everything in this video is clear. If you have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.